Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. This is the 14th tutorial of STAAD.Pro. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about dead load. So let's talk about it. There are four types of load acting on a structure. Those are dead load, live load, wind load, and seismic or earthquake load. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about dead load. After you are done with your geometry, cross-sectional property, and support assigning, you have to apply load on your structure. In the last video, we have learned how to assign support to our structure. And now this is time for load and definition. You will get load and definition just below the support. I'm clicking on it. Then you will get a window. From this window, we can define and assign loads to our structure. To do that, you have to click on this load case details option. I'm clicking on it. Then I have to go for add option. I'm clicking on this add option. This is the load cases window. We can define our loads from this window. For that, I have to click on primary option and I have to give the number of load. As it is the first one, that's why it is default number one. Now you have to choose the loading type. There is a lot of loading type. In this tutorial, we are going to learn about dead load. So I am choosing the dead option. I am clicking on it. And the next step is giving the title of your load. As it is dead load, so I am giving the name DL. So I am done and I will go for add option. If I click on add option, I can see that DL has been added under load cases details. In this tutorial, we are not going to discuss any other load type. So I am done and I have to close this window. So I am clicking on close option. Now we will work with this DL option. It is just a folder. We can store our load items in this folder. One thing you have to keep in mind that this folder is only for dead loads. So before defining dead loads, you have to click on this DL option. Then you will go for add. There are three types of dead load acting on a structure. The first one is self weight. The second one is member load, which is also referred as wall load. And the third one is floor load. At first, we will deal with self weight load. This is the weight of the structure, which never changes. It is always constant. Not only self weight, other dead loads are constant. That's why they are called dead load. Self weight is assigned by a factor along the gravity and it is always working in y direction downward. That's why the sign is negative here and the factor is on always. You don't have to calculate the self weight of your structure. STAAD.Pro will calculate it by itself. So here no need to change anything. I'm going for add option. As I click on add option, here I see the load item, that is self weight. As we didn't assign the self weight to our structure, that's why there is a question mark. No need to worry about this. When we will assign this self weight to our structure, this question mark will not be anymore. The next load item is about wall load, which is also called as member load. If I click on member load option, then there will be other options also, but all load is working as uniformly distributed load on our beams. That's why we have to choose the first one, uniform force. This picture looks little complicated, but don't worry about this picture. We are going to apply the all load on full length beam, so we don't have to specify any portion. So we don't have to think about the distance D1, D2 and D3. We just have to think about the all load, and it is always working in global wide direction downward, so we have to use negative sign here. Let's first define the load for main or outer wall. It's a uniformly distributed load applied per unit length. I hope you can calculate this wall load as I have shown in the picture. For my building, it is 17.4 kN per meter and it is negative. So I am inputting here -17.4. Then we are done and I will go for add option. I'm clicking here and my main or outer load has been defined as the second load item. Similarly, I have to define a load for my inner or partition wall. To do that, I will just change the magnitude here 7.64. Then I will click on add option. Then I got the load for my inner or partition wall. Similarly, I want to define another load for my parapet wall, which is 2.286. Then I will add and I will get the load for parapet wall also. Now we are just defining our loads. After completing definition, we will assign these loads to our structure. Now this is time for floor load. I am clicking on this floor load option. One thing we need to know that our floor load will work from the second floor and third floor. For the ground floor, we don't need to define floor load because there will be sand and that will give the support there, and that will not be calculated as a dead load. As we click on this floor option, we see a lot of options, but don't be scared. We will deal with the pressure that is acting on the slabs mainly, and it is working in global y direction downward. And here you have to give the range of your slabs. You can choose any range for your slabs. As I am not considering the ground floor, so our minimum coordinate of x will be 0, y will be 4, as the height of the first floor is 3 and this distance is 1 meter. So I will give the minimum y coordinate as 4. I am giving here as 4 meter, and the maximum y range will work in this node, and this is 3, 3, and 1, which is 7. So I am inputting here 7 meter. Similarly, I have to give the minimum x coordinate. For this point, coordinate of x is 0, which is minimum, so I am keeping the minimum x range as 0 meter. And for the maximum range, I have to know the coordinate of this node or this node. To know the coordinate of this node, I have to make my cursor as node cursor, and I am selecting this node first, and then I will double click on this node. Then here I can see that the x coordinate is 4. I am closing it, and I am giving the maximum x coordinate as 4. And for z range, I have to know the coordinate of this node. I am selecting this node and double clicking here, and here I can see the z coordinate is on and my minimum range is on for this structure. I am giving here 1 meter. And for maximum z range, I have to click on this node. I'm selecting this node and double clicking on it, and I see that maximum z range is 6. So I'm closing it and inputting here 6 meter. I hope you got this point. Now I have to give the load pressure, which is 5.127. So we are done, and I'm going to add. I'm clicking on this add option, then I will close. Now here is our load list, and we have to assign these loads to our structure. Here there is 4 question marks because we didn't assign them to our walls and structure, but STAAD.Pro has taken this floor load because my slabs are defined as plates, so this floor load only work on plates. That's why it is not question marked. And if I click on this floor load, I can see that my load has been assigned already. If you are not clear about range, then I can discuss about the range now and you will be more clear about range. To do that, first I am clicking on this load and go for edit, and here I will change the range and you will see the difference. If you want this floor load only on this portion, then you have to change the range from this area. To do that, first of all, I have to know the coordinate of this node. I am selecting this node and double clicking on it. Then I can see that here the coordinate is 2, that is maximum. I am closing it and I am inputting the maximum x coordinate as 2. Then I will go for change. As I click change, you can see the difference between the previous range and the present one. Anyway, I want to apply my floor load on the total floor, so I have to change the range again. First of all, I am selecting this node and double clicking on it, and here the x coordinate is 4, so I am closing it and giving the maximum x coordinate as 4. Then I will go for change, then I will close. Now it is the same as before. This is how range works. Now let's assign the self-weight to our structure. To do that, first of all you have to select the structure. Now our cursor is node cursor. To select the total structure, I have to make my cursor as beam cursor. So I am going there and clicking on this option and selecting my whole structure. Then I will click on this self-weight option and I will go for assign, but my this option is not alive, so I have to select my structure again. Then I will go for this option, then I will click on assign option, then I will click on yes. As I click on yes, my self weight option is not question marked anymore, so we can say that this is assigned to our structure. Let's click on the workspace, and now this is time for our main wall or outer wall load. This outer wall will act on this floor and this floor, but not this floor because we will use parapet wall. So I have to select the outer beams first. To do that, I will go to this select option, then I will go for beams parallel to X, and again I will go for select option, then beams parallel to Z. Then my beams are selected, but we don't need these beams and these inner beams, so I will press Ctrl and deselect these beams. My required beams have been selected. Now I will go for assign option. Before doing that, I have to select this wall load first. Then I will click on this circle and I will assign. So my outer wall or main wall load has been assigned to our beams. Let's click on workspace. Now it's time for the inner wall load. To do that, I have to select the inner beams first. My inner beams have been selected. Now I will click on this inner wall load, then I will go for assign, and at the same time there is no question mark. For parapet wall, I have to use this load. Before doing that, I have to select the beams first, then I will select the parapet wall load, then I will assign. So my loads have been assigned. If I click on any option, then you can see that load is being highlighted with a green color. So this is how we assign our dead loads to our structure. I have given hints how we calculate our dead loads, but we will discuss about calculation of dead loads in future in detail. This is all for today. In next video, we'll discuss how we define and assign live load to our structure. Till then, happy learning, keep practicing. See you in the next video.